Hello friends, let us now learn some important points about congenital diaphragmatic hernia. This congenital diaphragmatic hernia, here there is a diaphragmatic defect. So because of this diaphragmatic defect, through this defect the abdominal contents will herniate into the thorax. Through this defect the abdominal contents will herniate into the thorax. Along with that, there will be pulmonary hypoplasia will be seen, and you will also see that there will be intestinal malrotation are seen. So all these are associated with esophageal atresia. Then this is also associated with congenital heart diseases, and this is associated with omphalocele and trisomy 13 and 18. So if you were asked what is the most common type of congenital diaphragmatic hernia, the most common type is it is posterolateral, or we can also call it as Bock-Delec variety. That is posterolateral or Bock-Delec variety is the most common. It is most commonly seen on the left side, and it is most commonly seen in the females on the left side. So if you see the clinical features at birth, you will see that there is a triad. You will see that there is a triad of respiratory distress along with scaphoid abdomen. There is a triad of respiratory distress, scaphoid abdomen, and you will also see mediastinal shift is seen in the baby. And later in life you will see that there will be intestinal obstruction is seen in the baby. Okay, then how are you going to diagnose it? Diagnosis is you can do antenatal USG. In the antenatal USG, you can see it between 16 to 24 weeks of life, you can see. Or you can do a chest X-ray in the baby. In the chest X-ray, you will see that the bowel gas shadows, instead of being present in the abdomen, they are present in the abdomen, they are present in the thorax also. Because of them, they will cause mediastinal shift of the liver. Actually, lung will occur, the it shifts, lung shifts to the opposite side, and also you will see the lung on the side of the defect is not formed completely, so there is pulmonary hypoplasia is seen. So if you see the medical management, so baby with known or suspected congenital diaphragmatic hernia, then you will see that the baby will have severe respiratory distress. If there is severe respiratory distress, then you will have to do endotracheal intubation. Now, if there is any suspicion of esophageal intubation, if you think it is, you didn't do endotracheal intubation but you accidentally have done esophageal intubation, then first confirm the position of endotracheal tube. If you think it is not in right position, then remove the endotracheal tube and re-intubate. Okay, then if there is no severe respiratory distress, then insert a nasogastric tube. Insert a nasogastric tube, and then chest X-ray should be done to confirm the diagnosis, and then do the surgery. Okay, after doing esophage endotracheal intubation, when you are sure that you can, it went into the trachea only, then insert the nasogastric tube and then do chest X-ray. Here confirmation of endotracheal tube is not done with chest X-ray. It is done manually but not with chest x-ray. So this is the main treatment chart which you have to do. And one important thing is, in this neonatal resuscitation bag and mask, ventilation is contraindicated. And if you see what are the predictors of poor outcome, the predictors of poor outcome of congenital diaphragmatic hernia include: one is, there is severe pulmonary hypoplasia, presence of severe pulmonary hypoplasia, or if the lung head ratio is less than 1, or if you suspect any malformation associated is suspected, or if there are symptoms present in first 24 hours, or if you think the liver is in the thorax, liver into thorax, then it will be difficult to readjust or push the liver into the liver along its ligaments and everything into the abdomen is difficult, and they might need extracorporeal membrane oxygenation. If they require extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, then it is a poor outcome. So if you were asked what is the most common cause of mortality in congenital diaphragmatic hernia, that is pulmonary complications or pulmonary hypoplasia is the most common cause of mortality. Okay, so this is about congenital diaphragmatic hernia. Thank you.